Does Jamandi, the Wolf of Resto, think so little of me, sending such a dimwit? Did you really think I'd just fight you? Hey, idiots, cut him up. These lands are mine. I won't let you take them from me.
I won't be halted.
An expected result.
We do it my way. Onwards!
Just letting the ink dry.
State your desire. Learn how to use it first.
I'm losing my temper.
What troubles you?
Let us not hesitate.
Against me.
Shall overcome.
Get you out of our story. Anything else?
I lead. You follow.
Anything is possible.
Request.
Stand with me. I stand ready. Forwards.
We do it my way. Over there!
Serves you right.
Yes, I'm still here.
Can you make an epic piece? I need inspiration.
Who dares disturb me while I'm drinking?
I'm superior!
Mine! I won't let you take them from me!
Yeah.
magics should be used in other ways. These magics should be used in other ways.
I can't. Oh. After so long, I learned to stand. You know about.
I wrote it like I saw it.
Share your will. Ask.
Our time has come.
To pieces!
Let us strike as one!
Applause, please.
Your wish granted.
Applause, please.
I won't be halted.
These magics should be used in other ways.
Repent!
I never had a chance.
Ow.
My search was not in vain. I don't like surprises. Oh, sorry. Was lost in thought.
It's just not my lucky day. And Lindsay was called forth. Adventures call to them.
My search was not in vain.
I see something. Anything else? Applause, please. Applause, please. Anything else?
Don't like surprises.
failed. I'm sorry. Just letting the ink dry.
Rest would be welcome.
So you never change at all, Jaythorn. You're like a fly stuck in amber. No wrinkles, no scars. Even your hair is always the same length. That's so strange.
But you change, Valerie. Your beauty fades by the day. Don't you want to hold on to it forever? I could help.
Rest would be welcome.
You know, Harem, I don't think your Grotus cares about his congregation. What's the point in worshipping him?
And what's the point in venerating the other gods? All they promise their followers is empty fuss, pleasure, war, magic. For his part, Grotus teaches us to accept the inevitable with dignity.
Onwards! I'm better off without it. I won't take that!
Good work. Nice to see I haven't lost my intuition for people. Not many would have managed to set out to the Stolen Lands and return with the Stag Lord's head, but I knew you could handle it. Congratulations are in order. Today, you'll receive the title of Baron before the High Society of Restov, and even Natala Sertova personally. God's bless her. Tomorrow, you'll be able to return to the Stolen Lands if you wish, but this time, as a ruler. But matters of state can wait. For now, enjoy this feast in your honor. All the city leaders are here. It's a great opportunity to make some useful connections. Speaking of connections, let me introduce you to Cassil Eldori. He's my adopted son and apprentice. He's a trustworthy man. I'd like to send him with you as an envoy. Yes. Yes, you certainly have that right. But tell me, how well do you know Brevoy's history or the current political atmosphere? It won't be an easy explanation. What's now called Brevoy was originally two different countries, Rostland and Issia. 200 years ago, they were stuck in constant squabbles. Then, Coral the Conqueror showed up and united the two states into one. Such diplomatic tricks are easy to manage when you have dragons at your disposal. The so-called noble houses of Brevoy, mainly Sertova, Orlovsky, and Lebeda, once ruled over Issia. We, the Eldori, ruled Rostland. The royal house Rogarvia, founded by Coral the Conqueror, forced us into obedience. But 200 years isn't long enough to make peace with such a troubled history. Even 2,000 years wouldn't be enough for us to accept Issian rule. Brevoy is a country held together by a thread, and that thread grows ever weaker. We, the Eldori and the great noble houses, spent 200 years under the rule of invaders, the royal house Rogarvia. We plotted, we schemed, we stabbed each other in the back. But open confrontation was out of the question. But a few years ago, House Rogarvia disappeared. No one knows how or why, but one day, their manors were just empty. And the force that held Brevoy together, that kept us from a bloody feud, ceased to be. Brevoy is currently ruled by the House Sertova, the former kings of Issia. But their power pales in comparison to that of House Rogarvia when they were here. So now, Sertova and Eldori stand facing each other, staring each other in the eye, waiting for the other to draw their sword. It's an untenable situation. Rostland wants to regain its independence, and we will regain it. The power the Issians hold over us is humiliating and costly. The Stolen Lands are disputed territory. Brevoy can't appropriate them without raising protests from each of the neighboring states. However, if some brave people were to found independent states on that land, it would be another matter entirely.
My hope is that you and your future neighbors, Baron Hannes Drelev and Captain Magor Varn, will become our allies. But even your neutrality would introduce a powerful counterbalance to the aggression of the noble houses. Maybe, with your help, the inevitable division of Brevoy can occur without too much pain. We hope to get some help from the Myvani Aldori, the descendants of the Sword Lords who have fled from Coral's rage to build a new nation in the south. Restov is a free city, proud of its independence from everyone, including the Aldori Sword Lords. But when it comes to Rostland's liberation, our goals align. This whole plan is our joint creation with Lord Mayor Yosef Selemius. Actually, she could still intervene and disrupt the proceedings. But she's a Sertova. Their games are always complex and multi-layered. They're always looking for ways to turn defeat into victory. If she's decided to allow you to become a Baron, it means she already has some idea of how she can turn it to her benefit. Maybe she understands that Rostland will inevitably separate and she doesn't want a war. The more likely scenario is that how should I know? We're in the middle of a big game. And today, you move from being merely a piece on the board to being one of the players. I hope you have a better understanding of what's at stake. Of course, Keston gave me a full report. You don't think I'm trying to impose a nanny or a spy on you. Enjoy your evening. When you're ready for the official part, come to me.
I lead. You follow.
Will you drink with me? To beauty. It sweetens our happy days and brings solace to our dark and sorrowful ones. But jokes aside, I came to apologize. I know The words I said in our conversation with Lady Aldery might have offended you, but this was not my intention. The lessons life has dealt me were not easy. I've learned to be wary of new acquaintances, which is why I've refused to join your party. I hope you will forgive me for this weakness and for my harsh words. And I hope you will hear me out, for I have something to tell you. As it happens, I came across some very valuable information. What brave conqueror of these wild lands wouldn't be intrigued by news of an ancient shrine, possibly full of great treasures? A place such as this was discovered by my old friends from Kadira. And it just so happens to be located in the lands that today become rightfully yours. I'm sure you'd like to finally gain your official title and celebrate your victory. And I don't like noisy parties and ceremonies. So long, friend. I'll call you so today, because soon enough, all you'll be hearing is, Your Grace, Your Grace, Your Grace.
I won't be halted.
Thank you.
Like our little gathering, I hope you've made some useful connections. Shall we move on to the official proceedings? My apprentice, Kasil Aldori, will go with you, won't he? Oh, the heir of House Lebeda. Naive enough to think no one would recognize him here. I wouldn't trust him. Who knows what he has in mind? Excellent. Stand here. Lords and ladies, today we are here to honor three brave people who have done the impossible. They've tamed the stolen lands. Baron Hannes Drelev, the new master of Glenabon, Captain Maegor Varn, the conqueror of Dunsward, and finally, the tamer of the Shrike Hills, who put an end to the atrocities of the Staglord's bandits. Step forward. On behalf of the people of the free city of Restov, I confer upon you this noble title. Rise, your grace.
Victory. The Stag Lord's dead, and the capital of the new barony has been built in place of his fort. That was how the long and challenging Taming of the Stolen Lands began.